Once complete, Uganda's second international airport will have a runway of 3,500 meters length, 45 meters width, with shoulders of 15 meters each side. It will also have a platform of 75,000 meters squared, ready to receive four Antonovs 124 or Boeing 747-8 aircrafts. The airport will also have a cargo terminal, airport rescue and firefighting building, accommodation block with 30 double two-bedroom houses and six single three-bedroom houses, fuel farm, mobile air traffic control tower, among others. According to Amos Molise, the spokesperson of SPC Uganda Limited, the company undertaking the construction works at the airport, the government has not yet secured funds to set up a control tower at the new facility.
The gadgets in Entebbe to control the flights. As the government gathers money to control, to construct a fixed control tower on site, this should not stop the operations, and it should not affect the timelines of oil and gas.
The first phase of the project is expected to pave the way for the importation of heavy equipment materials and machinery by the oil and gas companies, which are currently in the initial stages of developing their own projects. Morisa says that the construction work, which currently stand at 91%, are only lacking a few components to finish the first phase of the work.
Plan is in phase one. The remaining components I can mention, it's a fuel farm, it's an air traffic control tower, accommodation for the airport operators. Very few components are remaining. Actually, the major component that is remaining and may take some money is the air traffic control tower. The government of Uganda thought it wise to have an international airport near where the refinery is going to be constructed, so that these heavy equipment can be thrown in straight away to the destination.
Molisa says, despite the challenges encountered in handling the project, they are positive it will be ready by September or October this very year.
We shall have this airport ready to host flights, in a sense that it may not be that fully complete, but we are doing it in phases. The first phase will be ready and it will be in position to host any flight.
Report by Jenan Tusingwire for the news.